Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series about RAG, Reactive Augmented Generation, and in today's video we will review how to build a multimodal RAG agent with the Gemini Pro and leveraging the whole process with the framework LangChain and the SDK of the Vertex AI, Google Cloud Vertex AI. As usual, I have created a notebook, and later on I will upload to the repository, and you will be able to download and to review the content of what you are going to see today here in your local environment. The approach to build a multimodal RAG is essentially or use all the information regardless the format that you had to build context and pass the context to an LLM as in the process of querying for about information or topics or some private information that you want to obtain. This information can be in PDF format, can be in HTML, can be images, can be audio, can be video. Here we will follow, first of all, we will do a pre-processing of this information in order to obtain a representation, a summary of the different components, the different parts of the information, of the types of the information we had. We will create a summary of these formats. Can be images, can be documents, text, can be audio, can be tables extracted from HTML, can be video. So we will pre-process. Pre-process means we will extract a description, a summary, or a transcription of the video, the audio, whatever you want to do with this, and that will be the text representation of that file, which and this text representation we will use is to create an embedding and introduce it into a vector store. In the vector store, we will introduce one side the summary of these documents, of these files, of this in these files in text, PDFs, images, audio, whatever, and beside that, we will upload the content of the documents in a text format. It is a document just extracting the text from the document, from a PDF, from a document, HTML, whatever, and it is an image or a video, audio, a binary format. We will transform this binary format into a Base64 format, which is essentially transform the binary into text in order to be able to save it into the vector store. In the last step, once we have all the information stored in the vector in the multi-vector retriever, we will create a chain with LangChain, which according to a query, we will pass this query to the vector store. The vector store will return the content, the documents. In this case, it will match, will look for similar content according to the summaries that we have created during the pre-processing from images, text, audios, whatever document or info we are going to use. It will find the most relevant documents according to the query that you have formulated, and then we will retrieve from the vector store the content, and in combination with the query, we will pass all these contents, regardless, o sea, it doesn't matter if it is text, video, audio, all of them in Base64 with their corresponding mind type. We will pass these documents as content together with the query, and we will pass all together to a final LLM to answer the question. So we will use all the information regardless how in which format the information is supported or maintained. Again, can be images, can be tables, can be text, can be audio, can be video. So the process is going to be the same. Today we will use images and documents, but the process of convert any kind of format, the file format, is going to be the same. We extract the text from documents, and we create a summary. With the summary, we will create an embedding, and we will add all together: content, summary, embedding, all together related with a single ID into the vector store. With the image, we will take the image, we will pass this image to the model, and during the preprocessor, we will create a summary. And we will do the same. We will take the image, the content of the image, the binary format, we will transform it to Base64 with the summary returned from the LLM during preprocessing. We will create a embedding, a vector embedding, and the embedding, the content in Base64, the ID, all these pieces will be part as well. Will be loaded into the vector store. When we want to use finally in the final step, when we want to query our information using a LangChain and LLM, we will use all this information in the multi-vector retriever to generate context according to the query that you formulate a query. The query, first of all, will go to the multi-vector retriever. It will obtain different documents according to which ones match or suit better to the query that you formulate, and it will return some documents for, in the case of Chroma, that is the technology that we are going to use to build this multi-vector retriever. And these documents could be text simply, or images, or in the case that you upload other formats, audio, video, or whatever. We will get the IDs of the documents, and then on we will obtain the content of these selected documents or returned documents from the retriever, and then we will add these documents in the corresponding format. Obviously, if they are binary, transformed into binary 64. And we will add the mind type in order to be preprocessed later on by the LLM. And we will add this content retrieved from the retriever together with the query. We will pass to a final LLM, and with this, the LLM will build an answer to the question that you have formulated. And again, you can apply this. Today, again, we are going to use PDFs and images. I will show you now which ones. And you can apply the same approach to other non-structured data. Okay, so to replicate this, I will patch you later on the repo. I will upload my requirement files. You can you need to install these libraries to work with that. We will use the integration in between LangChain and Vertex AI, the SDK of Vertex AI. We will use Chroma as a vector store to create a multi-vector retriever. And we will use LangChain Gemini Pro 1.5 0 1.5.0.0.2, the latest version of the multimodal model of Gemini. Okay, we, as you remember from other videos, I'm using in my access is the access to the Vertex AI is done with a service principal account or a service account that I have created to access to the API from my local environment or from a Docker. So it's the conventional or the best practice to when you are working on local or you are working outside Google to create a service account that access you via credentials. You can download this into a JSON file and initialize the access to the API as you see here on the cell number 7. And here as well, I'm using the here this probably is not needed because we are not going to use today the embeddings from Gemini. We will use the embeddings available on Vertex AI. So we import our keys. We top n. We import the libraries we need. We instantiate the credentials and initialize the access to the SDK, to the API, Vertex AI API. We download some files from this coming from LangChain documentation. It's essentially a PDF which contains text and some images, so we're using the PY PDF. I always forget the name, sorry. PY PDF loader. We can extract from one side, we extract the text. This is a document which essentially contain text and also contains some images. These images were how to say integrated probably in a doc document and then on the it was printed into a PDF into a PDF. Now when you use here PY PDF loader, you can activate the extract images and then you will get all the images that were inserted in the document aside. So from one side you will get the documents, the LangChain documents. You can check here. Oops, sorry. And a part of the documents, the LangChain document generated from the text, one per page. So let's do it here. You can check the docs 0. Oh, sorry, I had to let me docs 1. I will just do it again. I don't want to spoil the what I had down. That's why, oops. Come on. Ah, yes, I need to import this again, probably. Let me import it. Okay. Sorry, yeah, it's done. Okay, so with the PYPDF loader, you extract the image and extract images, you will get one side, the content of the document. And then if you check here, we have in total, let me just count the number of documents we have. And similarly, you get the images, as you can see here. Every image comes from a page. We have 21, one page. If you go to the page number 4. So you have here. It has extracted the table in such a format, which is not very convenient. And then on, beside that, is in the page number 5, obtains as well this image, with the one that you had here. similarly, you had the page number 6, which is the fight. You can see here as well on the PDF. Let me one second open it. Bot noise. Where is this? That one. Let me one second. And then this is docs. CJ. Open it. So you go to the page number five. This is the one that you saw before. Number 6 is containing practically no text. It's, you can pass. Packs down. This is page number 6, fight on the vector. If you check the page number 5, only contains that. So the idea, again, is one side we are going to use the text extracted. So secondly, we will use with the text extracted, we will create a summary of the text extracted. Secondly, we will use the images. The images we will pass it as well during the pre-processing to the LLM. We will create a summary, or you can extract as well the whole content and obtain some text that later on we will use create an embedding and upload it to the vector store. So processes every individual component that is going to be part of the information that you want to use as a private information to be used for the final LLM as context. You will first of all extracted. It is images, you will group them. In this case, we have text from the PDF, and also you have images. You can have as well audio, you can have video, and then on every document will follow a pre-processing that from where we will create a summary or a extraction of this format. It is a PDF. We will just create a document with a LangChain document, like in this case, with the extracted content. It is an image. We can create a summary or a description, detailed description of the image. It is a video or an audio, a transcription of the audio, a description of the content of the video, etc. All of them done with a multimodal model, as you will see here. First of all, we will create the summaries of the text. If you have tables, you can extract the tables from here. You can also parse this content and also create tables. I don't recommend you to do it with this. It's better to use PyPlumber, another library. You have it here. But we are not going to use in any case the tables extracted from the text. We will use it directly from the images. We will use the images. You can see here our images, all these images, all of them con 7, 6, 16, 10, and 5. The one here. We will use the images, and then first of all, as I said, we pass the text extracted from every page. We create a prompt, we create a chain here, so we create a prompt. The prompt and we create a model. The model again is just our Gemini 1.5 flash 002. We max tokens 1024, temperature 0. If there is a fail, empty response, which essentially return a error processing document. And the summarization chain, essentially we will pass the prompt to the model, and the str output parser will extract the text from the response of the model. So per text extracted per document, we create a summary, and we will have at the end of this process our table text summaries and table summaries. In this case, it's not gonna be, there was no tables. Not tables that comes from, you know, as you probably know, you can create as well a table in Word or in Excel and insert it in a work, and after that print it into PDF. This is a table. What we did here, or what it was done here, is inserted images. The tables that we inserted was these images. That was essentially the tool extracted images and not extracted tables, because all the tables that contains our documents come from images that we inserted with GPG or PNG format. Okay, so once we process this, we process all the text extracted page by page. We create a summary. We have our text summaries, in case that you have text, but your text table summaries into after being passed through an LLM to create a summary. We have links of summaries of every component. Text component that we extract. Now we do the same with the image. The image, we create this method to convert it in Base64. We create our model. Our model, the same, is the same model, same credentials, temperature by default. If I don't remember wrong, the temperature is, what is optional here? By default, is an ogron is one. In the case of LangChain, we create a modeling book with a human message. We pass the prompt. We will pass here to this, and the image in Base64. We here hard code the mind type is image base GPG in Base64, and this together with the prompt together with the image in Base64, we pass it to the model to generate a summary. So here in this process, we generate a summary for every single image that we had in this folder. At the end of the process, you have a list of images in Base64 and a list of summaries produced by the model. Finally, here we import from retrievers multivector, the multivector retriever. The multivector retriever, here we create this method which essentially receives a vector store, our text summaries, our text extracted from the PDFs, table summaries, tables, the tables itself with the summaries, if you have it, image summaries, and the images itself. So we are going to use the memory. We will not serialize this to Dix, and the doc ID is going to be the key to link all the components. When I mean the components, a set or as in this case in the multivector retriever, under the same ID key, you have an embedding, a summary, and the content. This content can be either the text extracted from a page, in this case of the PDF, it can be the image, an image in Base64, and you can extend this to audio as well in Base64, video in Base64, and so on and so forth. And then under the same ID, you had the embedding, the content, and the summary. The summary is the output of apply the pre-processing for that specific format and pass and ask a model during the pre-processing to create a summary or extract the content of this file format. In our case, from the text we ask the model to create a summary, and from the image we ask as well to create a summary. So in a single object in our vector store, in our multi-vector retriever, is going to be under the same ID the embeddings, the content in a string format, and the summary. And then on here, we create the object and the documents. We created, first of all, We pass a list of summaries or a list of contents. So this summaries is the summaries of the contents that you have here in the third component. Here the retriever. So here we have the summaries that correspond to these contents, and then we create an ID per content, and the summary docs, which is all the documents, is gonna be the creation of a LangChain document where the page content is the summary of the content, the summary produced during the preprocessing, and the ID is gonna be the UUID in format 4, UUID 4, that we generate here in this loop. So once we have created the documents, we add the documents in this process here. We are creating the embeddings with our embeddings model. We will see this now. And also we add a to the dot store the same. Here we create the embedding for the document, and we are adding the embedding, the content, and the ID, and link it to the same ID in the meta set doc store. We add the content of that specific summary and ID. So here we are doing the mapping with these two lines of code. And then we apply the add documents to the summaries of the test, to the summaries of the of tables, and to the summaries of the images. And here in images, we had the content of every single image in Base64. Here we had the content, which is nothing in this case, but of the tables in Base64. And here we had the text in text, because Base64 is a string, is text format. No? So if you will have a video or you will have audio, the process is pretty similar. The only thing that you need to do is, first of all, pre-process, extract the transcription, for example, of the audio. In here, instead to have the Base64 format of every single image, you will have the Base64 conversion of the audio. And here you will have in image summary, if you had audio, you had audio summaries produced by the model in this phase. You will have a similar method, but instead to handle images, you will handle audio, or you will handle video. Remember that if you are changing the format, if you are working with other data type that is affected in this case by the model, multimodal model, you have to change the mind type according to the type of document that you are sending to the model. In the case of Gemini 1.5, it accepts audio, video, images, different formats of audio, video, or images, and also text and PDFs. What more, once we had here done, here we create our vector store, Chroma, we give a collection name, and we create our embedding function. It's going to be a vector AI embeddings object pointing to the text embedding gecko and using our credentials. Here we pass, we create our retriever multivector image, and then we call to the method create multivector retriever with our vector store, text summaries, text, table summaries, tables, and image summaries, and content of the image in Base64. Which is essentially what you have here. So again, if you want to extend this with images or video, it's pretty simple. You just need to extend a little bit the logic here. Now we create here some additional logic to what? In the next set chain, we are going to, first of all, as I mentioned before, you formulate a query. This query is sent to the vector multivector retriever. The multivector retriever will use a similarity algorithm to match versus your query versus the different summaries of the content. you had, it whatever is, it will return a number of documents back. And then on with this logic, what we will do is the documents, you will, the match is done with the summaries, but what we're interested is on the content, not on the summary. So with this logic, what we want to do is retrieve the content of the documents that are the best matches to your question, to your query. And then on we create, where the, in this case we are detecting, first of all, we will see better the chain. Here in this with this method, we are creating the final chain where we will query the model and we will query the multimodal retriever. So we create our model and we create the chain. The chain, first of all, contains two steps in parallel. In parallel, first of all, is creating the context. The context is you pass your question to the retriever. The retriever is going to match your query versus the summaries. It will create an embedding of your query, and it will match with a similarity algorithm versus the summaries of all the content that you had in your multi-vector retriever. It will return 4 or 5, depending on the technology you are using, documents, and then on with this we will pass the output of the retriever to with runable lambda to split image text type. If you go to the here, we are detecting, we pass here the documents that we receive from the retriever, and then on from every document in the that we receive, we check it is an instance of documents. It is an instance of document. This means that it's a doc, it's a text, so we just extract the text. It is a here, it looks like Base64. In Base64, we simply are checking if this is an image. It is an image, we are resizing the image. And we are converting the image in Base64. And then this means that the among the documents, you can receive images, you can receive text, in our case, images or text. No more. And then on, if you are extending this schema, you can you will have to prepare. For example, it you will have to create another logic just to handle the case if you are using audio or you are using video. But in this case, we are detecting it is a doc. A launching document, we just extract the text. It is a image. We convert the image, we extract the image from the vector store, and we convert it to Base64. And it is test, just simply append the document. And then on, we finally return a dictionary with a list of images and a list of text. Case that if we had images, is a return. It is no images. We just return images in blank and text with the text. Okay, so once we return this dictionary with images and text, and together, so these two chains, how to say, run in parallel. First of all, we create the context and the question that you pass to the chain with the runable pass through, pass directly to the next step, which is the runable lambda. So the input of this parallel chain processing is the question, the query that you pass. The query is passed to the context, first of all to the retriever, the output of the table pass to with the runnable lambda to this function. The question pass as well to the second part of the or the second component of the parallel chain, the question, which is essentially same pass to the next step on the chain. So the output of this step, the first step of our chain, is a dictionary with two keys, context and question. And in the context, you will have the context retrieved from the retriever, can be text, can be images in the appropriate format, and the query that you formulate to the LLM, to the chain. This will pass to the using the runnable lambda to the image prompt fan. If we go to the image prompt fan, what we do here, first of all, we take from our data dictionary that remember that contain two keys, context and question. We take from the context the text, we create a simple single text, and we create a list of messages. The text message is going to be one side type text, the same that we create here. Remember how we create the summaries. The summary is we create a human message, the type text is a prompt, and the type image URL is a URL with the main type of the image and the base64 context of the image. And here, first of all, we create the text. The text is the a prompt, which contain one side data dictionary, our input dictionary with the question, and text and our tables are all the text that you we retrieve from the multi-vector retriever. We append the text message to our message list, and then on if we have any image in the context that we retrieve from the multi-vector store, we will handle it and we will create a image message per every image that we retrieve from the our multi-vector retriever. And we will do it similarly as you see about when we do the summaries on the images. You can do the same, but with video or with images, and the only thing that you will need to do is change this, create first of all the summaries and change the main type and the, a little bit the logic. Not a lot, to be honest. The only thing that probably you will need to change is the main type of the content in order to prepare correctly the message to be sent to the to the to the model. So here finally once we open all the messages, we just create a list with all the human messages. The human messages contain our text messages, which is the text with your prompt and all the text that we extracted from the from the multi-vector retriever, and all the images in base64. So again, the input of this step is going to be the question, the query that you make, and the context retrieved from the our multi-vector retriever, and the output is going to be a human message with all the content and the query that you had formulate. We pass this to the model will prepare an answer based on the context that receive and the query, and the output will pass to the str output parser to just format it and return you the text. And then here we create the multimodal RAT chain. We pass our multimodal retriever, and here we have the chain. Here we do a text. We query directly the vector the retriever multi-vector retriever. We invoke with this query what is the AB slash NTN and N TM Red Grove for MongoDB CloudFair and Datalog, and then on we get four documents. This is the basic, the default number of documents. If you take the one, is the image, and we are using this just to convert. You go to the PLT image base 64 doc 0. We simply are displaying the image using the base, the content of, we retrieve from the vector store, and it's the thing what we are doing here. So now we invoke the query, and then this is finally what we got from the. So we can review what it was shown. We just check the docs. We see what is the content that is going to be generated, and pass to the model to build the final question. But as you can see, it's gonna get this image, and the model is gonna prepare the information based on this image. You pass here the query, multimodal rack inbox query here, the requested information from table. The query is to get these values, this column, this and this, NT red ground and EB NTN red from MongoDB, Cloudflare, and Datadog. If you get here, MongoDB, EB NTN, red is 14.6 and grow 17, Cloudflare 13.44 and NTN grow 28 here. And Datadog 30.1 and 19. And that's all. The process, as you can see, is exactly the same if you pretend to use audio or video. We will prepare in any case something with some other information. But you will see that from what you see here, we just need to prepare a little bit modify a little bit the information that we have here. And we can create, maybe we extend in the next video a little bit with other images, maybe with audio or maybe with video. But yeah. What we had to do is everything had to be related to a topic, and then on everything had to be connected, and then from every piece you can get different information. So what we need to understand is how is the process itself. Is first of all pre-processing, creating the summaries, then on adding these summaries regardless from where they are coming from: text, image, audio, tables, meaning that Excel files or HTML tables, whatever, or video. We convert, we add all this information with summaries and embeddings into a multi-vector store. And then on we create a chain which use the information stored in that, no? And create the appropriate logic. First of all, to retrieve the content, because we are interested on the content, not in the summaries, and the content is the ones. The summaries, just we use it to find the most similar documents when we are at the first stage of the process here, at the beginning of the chain. We use the summaries just for that. We pass the query to the retriever. The retriever will use the we will create an embedding from this query, and we will use this embedding versus all the embeddings that we have created from the summaries of images, audio, video, or documents that we had in our multi-vector retriever. So once we have run the similarity algorithm, we are not interested anymore on the summaries. We are interested on the content. The content is what we will pass to the model in order to build the final answer. And then we will have to prepare or change a little bit the methods that we use to retrieve the content from the vector store in order to pass it correctly to the multimodal model and build the multimodal model be able to use it and prepare a correct answer back to you. Okay, that's all, pretty much all. Really interesting this stat. I will prepare more examples with other types of information. Probably I will change next time the model and also the framework using Llama Index. And then this way you have the choice to compare the two technologies. I tell you beforehand that it's going to be very similar. both frameworks works very similar. A little bit more simple, probably Llama Index, but at the end of the day, the concept is exactly the same. So how they use the vector stores, how prepare the information is exactly the same. Okay, thank you very much. In any case, that's all. I will upload this right away to the repository in order to you be able to download all this stat and replicate it in your local environment. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching the video to this point. I hope that you find it interesting and useful for your job, for your training, for whatever reason are you watching this video. And if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and make comments and all this stuff. Share with your friends and colleagues to help me to grow in YouTube. Thank you very much and see you soon.